done.
Thank you.
There!
On it.
Elizabeth?
No problem. All yours.
I had trapped the atom in mid-air. Colleagues called my Lutece field quantum levitation, but in fact it was nothing of the sort. Magicians levitate. My atom simply failed to fall. If an atom could be suspended indefinitely, well, why not an apple? If an apple, why not a city?
Can you unlock this? Back there at the shop, what you asked me to do.
Let's not discuss it.
No, what did that thing do to you?
If he were to take me back, that's death, Mr. DeWitt. Or something so like it, I cannot tell the difference.
You got empty pockets? Best keep on walking.
Thank you.
else I can find!
Elizabeth?
Bet.
Take a look at this lock.
I'll see what I can do. Have a look. Got it.
Thank you. Yes, yes. More of your finest wine, James. Consider this overdue recompense. Oh, wait, wait. Back taxes.
Tonight, the Prophet moved against his political enemies. He preaches mercy, but 40 souls lie tonight dead in unmarked graves. If a man was ever unworthy of grace, who would be my husband? But when I was beyond redemption, he offered it anyway. How can I deny forgiveness to one who with love granted it to me?
Pick this?
Really? That little old lock.
Done.
Looked at me and said, "Your family tree shelters a teepee or two, doesn't it, son?" This lie, this calumny, it followed me all my life. From that day, no man truly called me comrade. It was only when I burnt the teepees with the squaws inside that they take me as one of their own. Only blood can redeem blood.
Thinking about that dream that you had. New York on fire. There's something about it. Beyond that gate lies Comstock House.
Lady Comstock, how lovely to see you. Wonderful of you to make the journey, especially considering your painful death 19 years ago.
Lady Comstock?
The dress. The thing has mistaken me for my mother.
Your fingerprints do not seem to be your own today, Lady Comstock. Are you unwell?
This isn't going to work.
I think it can.
Your mother's dead, Elizabeth.
Yes. I think it's time I paid my respects. Let's head to where she's buried.
For the miracle child. Hello. I'm sorry your mother, Lady Comstock, is dead. I think she is altogether better than mine.
Look at those pennants. Seems like the Vox have chosen their favorite color.
Seems about right.
Since you live there, can you tell me why the tower has been closed? People say it's poor weather, then the pox, then a haunting. If it is a secret, I promise not to tell a soul. Your pen friend, Constance.
There's the graveyard where my mother's buried.
Where are you going?
Come on.
What are we looking for?
There it is.
Open it.
You bet.
It's your mother's grave.
They have her preserved in an airtight chamber. Her fingerprints will guess. In a Comstock house.
She's your mother.
A mother who abandons their child doesn't draw a lot of sympathy in my book.
Take a moment to think about what you're doing.
There. Will you open the door, or do I have to go in without you?
Elizabeth.
It's her. How are you, Mother? All locked up in there, huh? Looks like you and I have some common ground.
Let me do it.
No.
Let me do it.
Shepherd, and he has led you astray. What I do for love. What lion does not cringe to see their cub in pain? But spare the rod, spoil the child. If you won't listen to me, perhaps you will listen to your mother.
Elizabeth, are you all right?
Where did she go?
Hold on, you need to rest for a minute.
No, I'm getting that hand.
Elizabeth, why is your mother a ghost?
She's not. He used me to power that device. He opened up some kind of tear.
Mother is raising.
I've got
the
ammo.
Dead. Elizabeth!
There you go! What am I? My God. Is she the source of my power?
But what is she? Alive or dead?
Why do you ask what?
When the delicious question is when.
The only difference between past and present
is semantics.
Lives, lived, will live.
Dies, died, will die.
If we could perceive time as it truly was,
what reason would grammar professors have to get out of bed?
Like us all, Lady Comstock exists across time.
She's both alive and dead.
She perceives being both.
She finds this condition disagreeable.
Perception without comprehension
is a dangerous combination.
Look! Footsteps.
She goes to unfinished business.
We have to follow her. Convince her to open the gate to Comstock House.
It's a shame you have need of her to enter Comstock House.
Frankly, she doesn't seem all that cooperative.
There is a way to bring her to reason.
Three truths you must discover first.
Truths which, in this world, Comstock has destroyed.
If only one of you had the power to alter time and space.
That would be a blessing, wouldn't it?
Well, you're sarcastic.
There's something off about Lady Comstock.
Yeah, I noticed.
No, you don't understand. She doesn't belong here. I brought something through. I'm not so sure it was her.